Hey guys, how's it going, year 10? Nice to see you. I've got Dommy's in first. Dom, you always crack me up. I love the fact that you're always in first. It's amazing. You're a bit of a nerd, really, aren't you? That's definitely what you are. Right, I'll do the register. Let's get this done. There we go. So I've got... oh, need to pause the video. Sorry, pause video. Hey, Libby's not late today. Look at that. It's unusual. Oh, makes me laugh. Who have I got? I've got Lara. Got Atia. Got Dominic. I got Ryan? No Ryan yet. Got Lynn. Got Hal Ping. Got Libby. Yay, getting there. Still missing loads of people though. Oh, still missing loads of people. Let's see how long it takes them to find it. Sorry, I've recently realized you're staring at my ceiling, aren't you? There we go, folks. Sorry, I'm back. Sorry. Suddenly realized I wasn't doing this very well. There we go. Audra can't chat, but she is here. Ah, oh, thanks for letting me know. Hi, Ryan. Thanks for coming. Ryan's in the house. Ryan, I've got a bone to pick with you. You need to fill in the data, please. Amani, you too. You've got data that needs to be filled in. Ryan, you haven't put in a single bit of data. Not impressed. Come on, dude. Don't make me bully you into having to do it. I've got Amani, who's also not put in all of her data. But Ryan, it needs to be done today. Is that okay? Otherwise, I will send an email home. Deal? Ryan? This is where I think I wonder whether you guys log in and then disappear. I will not be happy. Ryan, what data? Oh, Ryan, I'll show you. I'll show you, Ryan. How have you missed this? How have you... I forgot, sir. Oh, Ryan, I'm not really mad at you. It doesn't matter. Ryan, you know, yeah. Like, just get it in... That'd be great. I'm going to quickly show you where it is. Oh, hang on a sec. Got more people arriving. Ananya, Caitlin, amazing. Ananya. Where's Ananya and Caitlin? Do it in. I like it. So I'm still missing Zach, Sophia. Tiffany's here. It's amazing. Tiff's here. Kayla. I know that Kayla's always having issues. Anyone know if Kayla's watching? Sophia's here. Yay. Hey, Sophia. Nice to see you. Mel, Kayla, and Zach. Yeah, there's Zach. Amazing. Great job, guys. Just Mel and Kayla to go. I'll mark them as missing. Oh, there's Mel. Oof, look at that. I'm just getting in there under the radar. Kayla to go. And I'll leave. I'll just put her as missing for now, and then I'll update it when she arrives. Okay, folks. By the way, can I say it's great to see you guys. Nice to see you on a Monday morning. I'm going to quickly just remind Ryan of the data. I'll also reshare it with you, Ryan, you know, just because, you know, I can. So this is the data, Ryan. I've been giving you guys out homework. This is the data, and everyone's seeing they're putting in their data, and then Audra hasn't done it, and it's nice that if Audra's watching, Audra will be able to fill that in for me. Ryan, and your data, Ryan, look, is entirely empty. Yeah, not a single bit of homework data in there. I'm going to share it with you now, Ryan, again. Yeah, I'll share it with you now. There you go. And go share. I might make it edit access. Yeah. There we go. Send. You're on it. There you go. Hide. So, Ryan, if you can just try and get that done by the end of the day, that'd be great. Obviously, by the way, obviously I know that you guys are going to be in lessons like all the time. Yeah, I had a chat with a Year 11 student on Friday. Over Hangouts, who said that she had 60 different Hangout groups. And I was like, that's so many, it's crazy. I can imagine you guys are exactly the same. So Ryan, just by the end of this evening, you know, just fill in your data, that'd be great. I'd really, really appreciate it. Audra, since you're watching, if you could do the same, that'd be great. That'd be fabulous. Okay, so guys, okay, year 10. Just letting you know, your exam is coming. Yeah, you have a test. I'm going to be giving you a full week to revise for this, for your calcs test. It is going to be, I'm going to be sending you this out on Google Form. So I'm very aware that students, of course, if I send you out a test, you'll be able to cheat. You can just Google it. Google. I don't know why I made that noise. No idea. But what I'm going to do is I am going to write all the questions myself. Every single one of them will be mine. And I'm going to put it onto a Google Form. Yeah. And you guys are then going to answer your questions on the Google Form. And you'll just submit the final end of the calculation, the result. Yeah. And then obviously it'll mark it for me. Can it be Tuesday? Because it's not early in the morning. No, Tiffany, I'm giving you a full week here. The other group, 10 D's, I think is on Wednesday. Yeah, they've got it first. No, tell a lie. Thursday. No, tell a lie. Friday. theirs is on Friday. Hi, Mr. Duncan. Sorry I'm late. Oh, thanks very much. Nice to see you, Kayla. I'll mark you as in. No problem. There you go. Cool, you're in. So, Atia, agree with Tiff. Guys, it's not going to make any difference. I'm going to send you out the link on Tuesday. No. Ugh! I'm going to send you out the test on... There's no point in me actually doing any date. Guys, I will send out the test to you on Google Form on the weekend. You can do it on a Saturday, if you like. That way you can do it whenever you like, and you'll have a full 24-hour period. Yeah, that gives you a full week to revise. I'm doing revision with you guys in the next couple of lessons. Yeah, but you'll have from today until I can send it out on Saturday, that way you can do it whenever you like. Yeah, that makes more sense. Thanks, Joe. You're absolutely right, Libby. No, Tiffany, saying that, you know, if you don't want it to be in the morning, that's perfect. I'll send it out to you on a Saturday, and you can then just do it at whatever time on Saturday. You'll have a 24-hour period to do it. In fact, I might only give you an hour. I might give you like an hour limit, a time limit on it. I've got to play around with Google Form, but we'll sort it out, don't worry. But guys, you're going to be fine. You guys have been the best at calcs I have ever taught. You're going to smash this. It's not even going to be a long test. It's going to be, there's going to be one question on every type. That's it. Nearly. I'll be about it. Anyway, so don't worry. Mr. D, your brain is literally gigantic of thinking of this. That's hilarious. Amazing. Wait, so our exam is on the weekend. Yes, Mel, I'll do it on the weekend. That way you can do it any day, any time on that day. That makes more sense. You can get up late, it'll be there. Huh? Huh? How good is this? It's amazing. Anyway, let's crack on. Everyone's bored. Me too. Right, let's go. Share screen. Boom. Oh no, I've just taken that off. I'm going to get rid of that one and that one. Winner. Right, guys. So, first thing I need to do, I've suddenly realized I've not finished this, have I? I've not got this. I need to go through the percentage yield homework. Let's get that on and running. I'll also do the other water crystallizations, but today, first thing we need to do is go through the homework of percentage yield. Is everyone okay with this? Are you ready to go through your homework, folks? Right, okay. So iron is made by the reduction. Now, I loved this worksheet. The reason why I love this worksheet is because you have got to do a reacting mass first. You had to do a reacting mass calc, which is awesome, followed by the percentage yield calc. Isn't that nice? This is such a great piece of homework. It's fab. Right, okay, so I'm going to shrink my pen because it's way too thick. Okay, so iron is made by reduction of iron oxide with carbon monoxide. Calculate the mass of iron that can be formed from 126 grams of iron oxide. Perfect. I'm going to make my pen a bit thicker. Okay, so step one is get to moles. We know this now, folks. Number of moles is grams over grams. So we're going to do number of moles is 126 grams of... Now, it tells us that it's of iron 3 oxide. It should say 3, by the way, there. It's a mistake on the worksheet. I'll be caught that one. But now we've got to put in the relative formula mass because it's ionic. So iron, of course, is, let's work this out over here. So we've got iron, of course, which is 56, plus iron 56, plus oxygen 16 times 3. Sorry, I should have just done that as times 2. Make it easy for myself. Times by 2, put it in brackets. I think that's 160. Sorry, guys, I'm just looking for my calculator. Right, sorry. So 160? Might be. So we've got 56 plus 56 plus 16 times 3. 160, winner. So I've got 160. So my answer to that now is moles is 126 divided by 160, and I get 0.78, technically 8, but I'm going to keep the real number is on my calculator. Yeah, Mr. Duncan, what about 24 hours on Monday? You'll have loads of lessons to do, Tiff. You won't be able to do it. You'll have all the lessons. I'm still going to teach you a lesson. I'll do it at the weekend. It makes more sense. Definitely. And that's moles of iron oxide. Right, guys, now I need to use the ratio. Step two, we know this. It's the ratio. And the ratio is iron 3 oxide to iron, because we want the mass of iron, is a 1 to 2. That's a times by 2. So I'm going to do 0.788 times by 2, but I'm using the number on my calculator. But we have, no, it's fine, but we have less time. You don't need that long to revise this, Tiff. You really don't. You guys have done amazing with your homework. So you're going to smash this. Don't worry. Don't worry. You've got a full week. Are you messing? You've got a full week to revise. Yeah? So times by 2, and I get the number of moles of iron as 1.575. Now, that actually becomes 5.836 fig, but I've kept it on my calculator, 1.575, and that's moles of iron. Right, now I need step 3, get out of moles. Yeah, out of moles. So, number of moles, reorganize. Number of moles equals grams over rams. Reorganize it, yeah, which is number of moles times by rams gives me grams. Right, how much does iron weigh? Well, iron weighs 56, which is great. So 1.58 multiplied by 56, and I get times the number on my calculator by 56, and I get 88.2. grams, and I'm done. Amazing. Mr. Duncan, is the ratio 1 to 2 because there is 2 ions and 1 to 1 Fe? No, Lynn. No. It's the ratio is up. There's an invisible 1 here and the 2 there. That's the mole ratio comes from the balanced equation. Yeah? The invisible 1 and the 2 in front of the Fe. Yeah, that's the ratio. The mole ratio comes from the equation. Yeah, so that's a 1 to 2. And we're going in that direction, so we're doubling it. Yeah. Mr. Duncan, could you do 56 over 126? I don't see the equation. Sorry. Oh, I haven't done the percentage yield bit yet. I've just got to the 88.2 grams bit of the mass output. So the second part of the equation, folks. Yeah. Second part of the equation. How Ping's gone mad, by the way, times by. You've gone, what? Oh, wow. Could you have done that? No. No, you can't. Hang on a minute. In this case, you can. How Ping, that is a fascinating bit of math that you've just done there. How Ping, that's worked for you. You got the same mass, didn't you? You can't do that. That will not work most of the time, Hao Ping. I need you to get to not do that. You've done a very clever bit of math, and I love the fact that you've understood. Wow, for you to do that, I haven't had someone do that in a while. What Hao Ping has done, folks, is Hao Ping has understood that because all of the iron that is produced comes from this one, he can do the percentage composition of iron in that compound. And that's going to come out as a percentage of it. And that's going to then multiply it by the mass of what's gone in, which will then give me the mass of the output. Blimey, Hao Ping, that's not allowed. Just so you know, in the GCSE exam, they'd give it to you. But just so you know, that won't work most of the time in chemistry. That won't work. Because the only reason why that's worked for you is because you produced an element. If you'd produced a compound, if you're working out the mass of carbon dioxide, you wouldn't get it. You wouldn't be able to do it. It's very impressive, though, but that is not a routine I want you to get into. That's not a good habit. Right, percentage yield. Write down our equation. Percentage yield equals actual over theory times 100, and that's going to give me the actual is here. Let's color code this. Yeah, actual is there. They had 78.5 grams. The theoretical, which you have just calculated, is here shouldn't do that the same color. That's just silly. Yeah, that one there is that one here. So put that in down here, 88.2, times it by 100, and I get 78.5 divided by 88.2 times 100, and I get a percentage of 89, exact 89%. We're done. Illegal maneuver. That's brilliant. Love it. Helping. I'm very impressed that you've managed to do that. But in reality, so you can't do that here, Helping. That won't work. Yeah, this next equation, I wonder if you're going to get many of them wrong because you've done a crazy way. You've just follow my methods. Right, next question. 50 grams of sodium chloride. Calculate the mass of chlorine that is formed. Right, okay. So, number of moles. Step one, get to moles. Number of moles is grams over rams. Right, who do I have? I've got 50 grams of sodium chloride. Sodium is 23. Chlorine is 35.5. Yeah. So add that together. I'm going to lose the mark if I do that. The answer is 58.5. Yeah. So there we go. So 50 over 58.5 gives me 0.855 rounded to 3-6-big, but I'm going to keep the real number on my calculator. This is moles. Next, step number two is, of course, the ratio. And the ratio here is a 2-to-1. Yeah, 2-to-1, and we're moving in this direction. The 2 comes from here. The 1 comes from the invisible one in front. And we're moving from there to there. So I'm going to divide this by 2. Yeah, so 0.855 divided by 2. I'm going to use the number on my calculator, though, which is 0.85470085 divided by 2. Gives me equals 0.427, but I'm keeping that number on my calculator. This is now moles of chlorine, Cl2. Right, next, step three is get out of moles. Number of moles times by rams will give me grams. How much does chlorine weigh? Well, chlorine, of course, chlorine is 35.5 on the periodic table, but it's in a pair. So times by 2, it's over 70. So it's times by, so it's 71. So 0.427 times by 71, and I get, using that number on my calculator, gives me that, and I get 30.3 grams. Yeah, rounded down. If you use the other number, you'll probably round wrong at the end. Next. So percentage yield equals actual over theory times 100. 25, the actual number, over 30.3 times by 100. 25 divided by 30.3, and I get 0.9 times 100. So easily done. 82.5. There we go. I like it. Cool. And that's percent. There we go. Next. Okie dokie. If you, Mr. Duncan, I got the same answer. Good job, Helping. Oh, what? You got the same thing and you were using your crazy percentage. Oh, because all the chlorines are in the chlorine answer. If they ask you for that one, Helping, it won't work. I need you to stop this, Helping. Please do not do what you're doing. You're cheating. You've gone mad. Please don't do it. If you want to try and do the percentage yield of sodium hydroxide, you won't get it right. Please, please don't do what you're doing. The annoying thing is your one's going to work again here. Oh, Helping, can you go back and do this sheet again and do it properly? I don't like it. It's upset me. I'm just worried that you've picked up a really bad habit. A really bad habit, and I've never taught it. Step one, get to moles, mass of chromium oxide, and then they want the mass of chromium. Your method will work again, Helping, because chromium's all in that particular one. Oh, don't do it. Number of moles equals grams over rams. Yeah, so I've got to convert. First thing I've got to do is convert that. 1.25 kg is times 1,000 is 1,250 grams. So 1,250 grams divided by the rams. Right, so what does chromium oxide weigh? I have no idea what chromium weighs. Chromium is 52. So I've got chromium is 52 times by 2 for, because it's, there's 2 of them in it. And then I'm going to add that to oxygen 16 times 3. No idea what that is. 52 times by 2 plus 16 times by 3. And I get 152. Right. 1,250 divided by 152. And I get, so my moles My moles is 8.22 moles, 8.22. But keep that number on my calculator of chromium oxide. It's actually chromium 3 oxide, by the way. They've made a mistake. Yeah, you'd have to put 3 there, Roman numeral. Just so you know, oxidation state of chromium is plus 3. You guys all know that. Step 2, ratio. Yeah, I've done it again. Thank you, Halping. I really appreciate that. I cannot tell you how much I appreciate it. Thank you. Yeah, it's just, I'm really glad that that's come to light, because it's a habit which, if you keep using it, it could be quite damaging. The ratio, again, is a 1 to 2. Doing lots of 1 to 2, so times by 2. So 8.22 times by 2 gives me, I'm using the number on my calculator, which is 8.22368421 times by 2. Gives me 16.4 moles, because I haven't rounded yet. So I've used the number on my calculator, and that's moles of chromium. Right, now I've got moles of chromium, now I just need mass. Get out of it. Step 3, number of moles times by rams gives me grams. Right, so 16.4 multiplied by 52, which we looked up before. I'm using the big number on my calculator, by the way, not that 16.4. And that's going to give me 855 grams, 3 sig fig. No, yes, yes. Or if you prefer, 0.855 kgs, if you prefer, if you want to convert it back. Right, percentage yield is actual over theory times 100. So the actual was 756 grams over. Now, I should use the real number on my calculator. I can do that, actually, which is rather irritating. Yeah, I'm actually going to do that. I'm going to put over 55 times 100, but I'm going to use the real number on my calculator. So I'm doing 756 divided by 855.2631579. Yeah, times 100, and I get 88.4%. Lol. There we go. Did that question method work for question 3-2? Yes, it did. His method, Sophia, did, because the reason why his worked is because he's going from here to here, and all of the chromium he is making is in the original product, sorry, the original reactant, which means if he works out the percentage of chromium in that, yeah, and then multiplies it by the mass of the input, he will get the correct mass of the output. But you do not want to do that, Sophia, because that will not work for 9 out of 10 GCSE questions. And the fact that it's worked for the last 3, I did that too. Sophia, can you go back, please? And can you redo them using moles, please? It's really important. I got... this one probably won't work. Although all the hydrogen is in the ammonia. That's really funny. It might work. You'd have to multiply it up rather than dividing it. Anyway, let's run it. Let's run it. Calculate the mass of ammonia that can be formed. This won't work. I'm sure this won't work. The ratio is all odd as well from hydrogen. Calculate the mass of ammonia. Sorry, mass of ammonia is that one. Right, so 12 grams of hydrogen. Step 1, get to moles. Number of moles is grams over rams. Hydrogen weighs 1, but it's in a pair, so times by 2, yeah, so over 2 gives me 6 moles, yeah, 6 moles of H2. What's the ratio? That's tricky. Step 2 is the ratio, yeah, and the ratio is 3 to 2. That's awkward. So we're going to divide by 3 times by 2 in 2 steps. So I'm going to do 6. Divided by 3 gives me 2, times by 2 gives me 4. Yeah, so I'm going to make 4 moles of ammonia. Yeah, right, step 3, get out of mass. So number of moles times by rams equals grams. So I've got number of moles is 4 times by 17. 4 times by 17 gives me 68 grams. Exactly. Right, next, actual over theoretical. Yeah, so I've got percentage yield equals actual over theory times 100. Yeah, gives me 20.3 over 68 times by 100. Yeah, so 20.3 over 68 times 100, and I get 29.9% rounded up winner. There we go. Question four worked. Helping! If the thing gets split, it won't work. Right. Okay, guys. So, give them three reasons why it's less than 100. Now, guys, I've been teaching most of you a long time now, since year nine, and I'd love to think that you guys recognize certain equations. Ammonia is the most important chemical in the history of mankind, and that equation should have been reversible. So I need you guys to recognize the Haber process. The making of ammonia is the most important one in history. And the top answer here, but I will accept if you've written something else. Yeah, number one, reaction is reversible. Yeah, reaction is reversible. Yeah, top answer. Next, number two, incomplete reaction. Yeah, incomplete reaction. Number two, impurities. Impurities in reagents. We're done. Yeah. It all seems reasonable, doesn't it? You can also have side reactions. Number four, alternative products. Alternative products. Yeah. Next, right. Calculate the mass of titanium. And yes, helping it will work as well. Mr. Duncan, does percentage yield have something to do with the limiting reagents? No, it doesn't. It can do. No, it wouldn't do actually, Mel. That's a very good question. No, it doesn't have anything to do with it. Because the questions won't... that's a really good question. I'll come back to that when we're doing limiting reagents. Definitely. Right, calculate the mass of titanium from titanium chloride. 10 kgs, first step. 10 kg. Is 10,000 grams, can't forget to convert. Right, next, number of moles is grams over rams. We always write down the equation to remind ourselves. So I've got 10,000 grams divided by the relative atomic mass, or in this case, formula mass. Oh, tickle's actually covalent. That's a standout one, by the way, guys. That's cool, isn't it? That should be ionic, but it's not, it's actually covalent. Yeah, same as TiO2, that's why you can't run electrolysis on titanium. It's not ionic, it's covalent. So we've got titanium chloride. How much does that? I have no idea what titanium weighs. 48 for GCSE. So I've got 48 plus 35.5 times 4. If you've done that, you lose the mark. Yeah, you cannot leave it like that, folks. You cannot do that. Yeah, you've got to complete it. The answer is 190. Yeah. Right, so we're going to get moles. 10,000 divided by 190 gives me 52.6, but I'm going to keep that number on my calculator. Yeah, that's moles of tickle. Tickle, cool, 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 cool. Yeah. Next, step two is ratio. The ratio is a 1:1. That's nice. Cool. So Ti 52.6 moles. That makes it easy. Yeah, but we still get a mark in the exam, by the way, for writing that. Looks like a smiley face. Still get a mark for writing that down. Step three, get out of moles. Number of moles times by rams gives me grams. Right, so 52.6, but I'm using the number on my calculator, times by titanium, which was 48. Times by 48. So 52.631575 times 48. No, ruined it. Darn it. I missed it on my calculator. 10,000 times 190 times by 48 gives me 2,526 grams. Or if you want it in kilograms, 2.53 kilos. If you want to do 3-6 fig, yeah, then it would be 2,530 grams. That's fine. Right, percentage yield is actual over theory times 100. So 1,950 divided by 2,530 times by 100. 1,950 divided by the answer that's actually on my calculator, which is 2,526.315789 divided by answer equals times 100, and I get 77.2 percent, and I'm done. There you go, folks. By the way, if you've rounded midway through, but if you've got numbers really similar, I'm not bothered about the rounding thing today, folks. I'm not focusing on that. Yeah, let's go through the marks. Yeah, I'll do it in red. So we've got one mark for 58.2, one mark for 89. But if you get numbers really close, you can have it. 30, 82, 855, 88.4, 68, 29.9, 123, and that one, and that one. You can have 2530 if you want. So total number is out of 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 13. It's out of 13, folks. So if you can put your data, folks, by the end of the day, if you can add your data to this, that would be amazing. Really appreciate that. Thanks, guys. 13 out of 13, Lara. Smashed it. Well done. Right. Let's go back to the lesson. Don't have a huge amount of time left. Got 20 minutes. Right. I like it. Title is Limiting Reagents. That's there. There we go. Title is Limiting. I'm actually giving both names now, folks. Limiting Reagents, or brackets, sometimes referred to as excess reagent calcs. Yeah, excess reagent. I'm just going to put calc at the end of that. Calcs. Okay, learning objectives. We know these. Number one. So understand excess. Ooh. Understand excess and understand limiting. They're different. It's looking at, they're the same coin, but from opposite sides. Just so you know how cool's that. Same coin, yeah, different opposites. These are opposites. Next one is understand why we ignore excess reagent. Be able to identify excess reagent. Excess stroke limiting reagent. These are my learning objectives for today, folks. Three understands and unable to. It's going to be tricky. We'll see how we get on. Okay. So the first thing I think we should do is give our definitions. I think everyone could agree with that. So definition, excess. The word excess literally translates to more excess. There we go. More than needed. More than needed. So it's like me. I ordered pizza last night and I ordered an XXL, an extra, extra large pizza. I only ate like four slices of it and the rest of it was in excess. Yeah. So more than needed. So I'm trying to think of an example of this. E.g., I have 100 grams of titanium chloride, but only needed 50 grams. So that would be considered in excess. Yeah, I have 100 grams, but only needed 50. This is deemed, that means tickle. Tickle is in excess. Yeah, let's go for the next one. Limiting reagent. Try and zoom in if I can. There we go. Definition, limiting reagent. I want to try and make it similar to this one. When you do not have enough to use all The problem is it's all other reagents. This one's a bit more tricky, this one. All other reagent. Now this one's quite clever. You realize that this one almost seems like it's independent of the other, but in fact it's not. So what I now need to get you to realize is because these are the same things, but in opposites. They're, as I said, part of the same coin, but opposite sides. I want to get you guys to understand this in terms of an equation. So if I had A and B, yeah, and I'm going to make AB, and I said that this is going to react, that the ratio here, the ratio is 1:1, yeah? And I am given 10 moles, so moles. I am given moles given, 10 moles of A. Let's say we've got 10 moles of A. The ratio is 1:1. And I've been given 10 moles of A. How many moles of B, year 10, do I need? How many moles of B do I need? Let's see who throws it on the chat. How many moles of B do I need? Who's going to be first? Who's going to be first? Oh, Lara's coming first. First place is Lara's. Good job. Well done, Lara. That was obviously spot on 10. 10. Lara's on 10. Who's going to come up with the second one on the left? Come on. Who's going to come in close second? Come on. Second. Come on. Come on. Who's going to be second? Well done, Lara. Smashed out of the bag. No one else is even listening. I feel like everyone's wandered off. I want to see how many other people are live on the chat. Come on, folks. Show me who's still here and not wandering off having lunch or something or breakfast. Lara, I think it might be you're the only person still watching. But well done. 10. So the answer is 10. I'm going to need 10 moles of this guy. Ah, there's Zach. There's Zitlin. Well done. That's great. Yeah. We realize that we need 10. Yeah. We need 10 moles. So what happens if I am only given 5 moles? So my next question to you is, who is in excess and who is limiting? Who is in excess and who is now limiting? I'm just wondering who's going to be the first person. I don't know whether or not people have paused the video because I went too quick through the questions. Totally possible. Yeah. A is excess, B is limiting. Well done. A, we have more than enough. A, I should color code this. A is in excess. Well done. That is correct. And B is limiting. Well done, Lara. Well done, Atia. And I'm going to change my color. And this guy is said to be limiting. Do you see what I mean by same coin, opposite sides? Really interesting. Yeah, excess and limiting. Okay, so what we now realize is in order to do this, in order to work out if you are limiting, you must be in moles. Grams won't ever help you. Yeah? So I think the first thing we can do is we can tick off these two learning objectives. I think most people are kind of going, this is kind of straightforward. I'm okay with this. Yeah? The next question is, why do we ignore the excess reagent? Okay, folks, let's see if we can do the next one. So guys, now that you've given me the answer to this question here, here's my last question. How many moles of A, shouldn't do it in blue because there's no relation, yeah? How many moles of AB will I make? Let's see who can get it. Who's gonna get it? Boom! Yeah, sorry. Terrible singing too. Terrible singing. Hi, well done helping in Sophia, straight off the bat, that's amazing. Atia, well done, good job. Absolutely spot on. Cool, good job, guys. So the answer is 5. I'm gonna get 5. Now, the reason being is, what we realize is this guy here is limiting us, whereas this guy here We have too much. Yeah, and we know this. These are the definitions. We have too much. So we ignore excess and go on limiting. And it's a one-to-one between B and AB. So B to AB is a one-to-one ratio. So if I had five limiting, I've got five outputs as well. Cool, right. So we can now kind of say why we ignore. And the reason why we ignore, just to show you an answer here, why do we ignore? We ignore, yeah, more than needed. That's why, because we've got more than we actually need. Yes, I think everyone would agree with that. Yeah, more than needed. Okay, now we're going to go to some real calculations, folks. Some real calculations. Okay, right. So the great thing is now, limiting reagent calculations. Now, limiting I'm an idiot. Reagent. Yeah, or excess, whichever one you want to call them. They can do them either. Limiting reagent calcs. Yeah, okay. Limiting reagent calcs is normally the name given. So I'm going to give you, we're going to start easy and steadily get slightly harder. So we're going to go question number one. Question one. Here's my equation. Sodium. Actually, I'm suddenly realizing this is a little bit tricky. I need to be careful here, folks. Can this be done? Yes, I'm sure it can be. It's horrible. Suddenly realize I've gone and given myself a royal headache here. Darn it. I've ruined it. Absolutely ruined it. I apologize. Sorry. I'm gonna have to it just shows how tricky that actually can be. I've gone and ruined that. Thought this was gonna be really easy. Right, here's the equation. Done. Yeah? Here is the equation. Yep, sodium metal solid reacts with green chlorine gas to produce white sodium chloride solid. Yeah, what happens to excess during reversible reactions? Ooh, checked you out, Libby. well, in reality, tuna. I have no idea why someone's just said tuna. But Libby, your question is valid. The answer is you will never really know which particle is going to be in excess because when they turn back, other particles won't react. There would still be unreacted gases. Yeah? Oh, that's a really hard question. If I was going to... A and B. Yeah, let's put A in excess. Yeah? Everyone agrees. A is in excess. Yeah? A, excess. B, limiter. B is the limit. Let's write down an equation. A plus B goes to, in a reversible reaction, Libby, AB. Yeah? 2NA, come on, Mr. Duncan. Oh, have I not balanced it? I didn't balance it. It's balanced. What are you talking about? Right. So, Libby, in terms of reversible reaction, these two now combine to give me AB. Yeah? Oof, gone. Yeah. Then they split apart to form AB. Poof. And then B joins with him to form AB. Poof. And then A and B fall apart to give me A and B. Poof. B reacts with him to form AB. Poof. You kind of get the picture, don't you, Libby? Would the AS, yes, they would. They'd alternate, absolutely. But we would still say that we know that the ratio was 1:1. We were given 4 moles of A, yeah, 4 moles of A and 1 mole of B. We realize that this one here is limit. This one here is excess. Limit, I'm going to make 1 mole of AB. One mole product. Yay! Even at an even rate. Yes, you'll establish an equilibrium. The rate at which the forward and backwards reactions are occurring at equal rates. Yes, Libby. If you're now doing equilibrium, and I don't really want you to yet. We're not there yet. Right. guys, this now becomes the reason why I was saying this becomes easier for me is because I can kind of just make these ones up. If I go 10 grams of him, 10 grams of him, here's my question, folks. Number one, question one, who is limiting? Limiting reagent, question mark. Next one, who, question two, who is excess? Who is excess? And number three is what mass of sodium chloride am I going to make? Yeah, right. Guys, I would like you please to pause the video and have a go, please. I will give you one hint. You need to find moles. You need that. Yeah, okay. So, first step in this process is I need to get to moles. Grams, number of moles equals grams over rams. I have 10 grams of sodium. How much does sodium weigh? Sodium weighs 23 on the periodic table. Yeah, the two has nothing to do with it. That's part of the ratio step. 10 divided by 23. And I get 0.435 moles. Agreed? Next, how many moles of chlorine do I have? Now, chlorine on the periodic table is 35.5 times by 2, which gives me 71. Over 71. 10 divided by 71 gives me 0.141 moles. Now, at this point, I'd probably say that you guys are going to say, I now know who's in excess. But you have to be careful. There's a ratio in here, folks. This is a little bit more tricky than ever. This is why this is last on the... Oh, darn it. I thought that was going to be... Yeah. This is why it's last on the calculations list. This is your level 8-9. Yeah. So now we need to look at the ratio. Yeah. The ratio is 2 to 1. That means for every 2 of those, 1 of those is used. So what we're now going to do is we're now going to do a trick that I've been teaching for a while now. Cover somebody up. Just cover up this guy. Just cover him up. Oh, I didn't want that. I wanted that to be completely... I wanted that to... Oh, no. Sorry, folks. I wanted that to not be see-through. And I don't exactly know how to change it either. Delete. Shape. I want a fill-in shape. Basic shape. Link to that. No, I want fill-in shape. Why did that not just fill it in for me? I don't know how to... ink shape. Ink to shape. Let's try this, see what that does. Oh, it's a nightmare. I don't really know how to do that now, folks. That's rather frustrating. I just feel like I want to find out how to make it work. Let's just cover this up. Okay, that's annoying. Irritating. Let's just stuff it. Let's just cover this up. Yeah, let's just get rid of that. Let's not talk. Cover it up with my hand. Right, let's just imagine for a minute that I have only got the ratio. This bit here is missing. I can't see that. I'm going to cover that up with my hand. So the question is, how much of chlorine did I need? Well, if that's the moles of sodium, and this is a 2-to-1 ratio, I'm going to divide that by 2. So 0.435 divided by 2. And I needed 0.2175 was needed. That's really important. I know this is a tricky thing, folks. There's only one of these questions on every paper. Is needed. The question now is, how much did I have? The question is, do I have enough? And the answer is no. Yeah, this one, I do not have enough to use all the sodium. What that means is this one is limit. Yeah, limiting reagent is chlorine. It's really hard, this I know. Limiting reagent is chlorine. Who is in excess? Sodium. We've got more sodium than I can use. So the sodium goes into excess. I now ignore the excess one and go to limiter. Yeah, so I'm going to use these moles here to work out my chlorine, my sodium chloride. Sorry, I should get rid of all of this now. I'm going to not use that to work out my chlorine. I'm going to use that to work out my sodium. So I'm going to do 2-to-1, double it. 0.141 times by 2 gives me 0.282 moles due to limiter. Yeah? And then multiply it by 58.5 to give me grams. Yeah, mass of it. It's really hard, this, folks, I know. 58.5. 16.5 grams. 49, really, on the calculator, but there you go. Guys, this is really tough. Yeah, I'm going to give you one more. I know that the lesson ends in 3 minutes. I'm going to do one more example. And the great thing is it's very easy for me to make these up. Now, year 10, if you are struggling with any of these things, you know, just pause the video, go back, watch it again if you need it. Take your time with it. Let's run a process again. Question number 2. So let's do the reaction between calcium and chlorine. You're going to see why I've just suddenly had an epiphany. Oh, there we go. Right. And look what Mr. Duncan, could you go through the third question again, please? Yes, I can. Absolutely. So I asked for the mass of sodium chloride. What we realize is this question here is a reacting mass question. That's reacting mass. Yeah. So what I need to do to work out the mass of this guy, I need to do step 1 is moles. Step 2 is the ratio. Step 3 is get out of moles. Okay, so the question is, where do the moles come from? Well, the problem is I had 2 sets of moles. I had the moles of sodium and the moles of chlorine. And I needed to find out who is in excess so I can ignore it. Yeah, I have got lots of moles here and very few moles here. Chances are the sodium is in excess. If I always say to students, if you ever calculate moles and one is substantially bigger than the other, it's going to be in excess. So I would predict that this one would be in excess. Yeah, but I still had to run my ratio. So what I did was I said the ratio from sodium to chlorine is a 2:1. So I divided my moles of sodium by 2 and I got this number. I need that much to react with all of this, but I don't have it. This is limit. Yeah, that's going to slow me down. So that number now is what I use in this step. Yeah, the moles, find the moles of chlorine, 0.141. The ratio of, I don't know what my laptop has just done, but I have just managed to go, it was really strange. Sorry, that was a horrible noise. The ratio of chlorine to sodium chloride is a 1:2, and I'm going in that direction. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to multiply those moles by 2, 0.141 times by 2, which will give me 0.282, times that by sodium chloride's mass, which is 58.5. Does that make sense? Does that help, Lynn? I'll do the next one, and then I'm going to leave you guys be. You know, the lesson's coming to an end, and it's break time. Right, I'm going to give you, let's do the same thing, 10 grams of him and 10 grams of him. Yep. Yep, thank you. You're very welcome, Lynn. Very welcome. Right. So, step number, I want to know, question. Let's run the questions. Question 1, who is excess? Question 2, who is limiter? They're obviously the opposites of each other. And question 3 is, what mass of calcium chloride do I get? Yeah? Right. First step, moles. Number of moles is grams over grams. Calcium weighs 40. So I get 10 over 40, which is 0.25. It's nice and easy, isn't it? 0.25 moles. Right, chlorine over 71, because chlorine's in a pair. 10 over 71 is 0.141 moles. Right, I'm going to make a prediction. I'm going to predict this number here. This one here is bigger than that one. Yeah, there's the mass bit here. What that means is chances are I'm going to predict that this is in excess. But let's just proof this. The ratio is 1:1 between these two. I would have to have 0.25 moles of chlorine to use up all of this. Yeah, do I have it? No, I don't. This is limit. Yeah, the other guy is in excess. Right. So now I now need to work out the mass of this guy. And I'm going to use my limiter. The excess gets ignored. And the ratio, so we've got step one is moles, 0.141. Step two, ratio, it's a 1:1. Look, 1:1. Yeah, that means the number crosses over. So I have 0.141 moles of calcium chloride. Right, turn it into mass, step three, times by rams. That is going to be 40 plus 35.5 times 2, so 40 plus 71, and I get 111. So that times by 111. So 111 multiplied by 0.141, and I get, I am going to make 15.65 grams of calcium chloride. Guys, I've overshot my lesson. I know this, and you guys back. Right. Guys, I know this is hard. I do. This is the hardest one. This is your A star. Yeah? They don't even include an excess reagent on all GCSE papers. They don't always do it. It's about every other year that they tend to include it. I don't want to rush this. Yeah, this here, if you can understand this is the first step through to A level. Yeah, because excess comes up a lot at A level, because they realize that no one ever measures out the exact moles of anybody. Yeah, they just kind of measure out bits and pieces of all kinds of people, and you need to work out who's going to be in excess and who's limiting. So don't worry. I will set you guys some homework. Yeah, I'll put a couple of questions. Now, guys, don't feel pressured. If you can't do it tonight, don't worry. Yeah, I'm just going to then go through them on the webinar next time. It'll only be 3 or 4 questions on excess reagents. And actually, this is a great opportunity to say to you guys that if you don't understand it, if you're going, God, no, I'm looking at these questions, I'm annoyed at what I'm doing, that's perfect. Because I will go through those questions tomorrow, and then I'll set you another limiting reagents exercise to reinforce it. Guys, have a great rest of your day. It's good to see you.